Welcome to Back to Basics. I'm Maya Chitani, a solutions architect from Amazon Web Services. Today, we're going to be walking through monitoring and observability for your containerized applications. How do we take those metrics and visualize them as well? So prior to this role, I used to be a cloud engineer, and a lot of times I got woken up early in the morning because there was a code push to production that broke the infrastructure, and our customers couldn't access our web application running on containers. So as a cloud engineer, I needed to dive deep into where the problem was, what the root cause was, and how we can prevent it from happening in the future. We also needed to make sure that our infrastructure was scaling in the backend depending on the level of traffic that we were receiving. So how do we do that? You want to first baseline your applications on how it operates during non-peak time. If there are anomalies from the normal pattern, you can investigate this before a major event such as a new product launch where you're expecting high levels of traffic. Well, you really don't want to be continuously woken up early in the morning to investigate what went wrong if there are any interruptions to your service. Let me show you an AWS native architecture pattern for monitoring your container environment. Let's start off with the container application running in Amazon ECS. You can see one of my favorite services, AWS Distro for OpenTelemetry, talking to the application as a typical sidecar architecture pattern. The application is sending its metrics via the AWS Distro for OpenTelemetry collector. It's also correlating distributed traces and metrics, then sending it to the Amazon Managed Services for Prometheus. I like Amazon Managed Services for Prometheus as it's a Prometheus-compatible service that lets you monitor and alert for your containerized applications and infrastructure at scale. You can also benefit from enhancing your container metrics via Amazon CloudWatch Container Insights. In the past, with Amazon CloudWatch, you needed to enable custom monitoring of services and tasks. With CloudWatch Container Insights, it provides several key metrics such as your container's CPU and memory utilization and task and service counts out of the box. Amazon CloudWatch, AWS Distro for OpenTelemetry, and Amazon Managed Services for Prometheus are all great data sources that collects, monitors, analyzes, and acts on all the things that are going on in your system. If you're a cloud engineer, you'd definitely like to see these metrics that you're collecting on a dashboard. So let's talk about how you can take these different sources of data and visualize them using Amazon Managed Services for Grafana. Amazon Managed Services for Grafana will help you visualize all of these data sources into a nice dashboard like this. You can analyze your metrics, logs, and traces without all the heavy lifting. There's no need to provision servers, configure and update software, and you can also connect your existing identities via AWS single sign-on. The top three metrics that you want to look out for in your container applications on ECS are, number one, CPU utilization. If this metric is nearing capacity in a single service, you might consider updating that service to include more tasks. High CPU utilization may indicate CPU-intensive workloads. If this is happening, consider upgrading to a task with a higher vCPU. Number two, memory utilization. ECS will terminate any containers that exceed the hard memory limit. If you set one, you'll want to alert your team when memory utilization approaches 100% so that your containerized application remains available. Even if you set a soft limit, memory utilization can exceed 100% without ECS killing containers. However, it's still good to know whether you're approaching this threshold, as it can help you avoid unexpected out-of-memory errors for your EC2 instances or unexpected high Fargate bills. As with CPU utilization, it's great to know if you're adequately scaling your ECS services. And lastly, running task count. You can track the number of tasks running within a container instance, service, and cluster. The metric running count can also show whether your services are running tasks as expected. When creating or updating a service, you can specify not only the number of desired tasks, as in how many tasks the service will attempt to keep running, but also how many tasks from a previous deployment you need to keep running while new ones are launched. In this session, you'll learn all about an AWS native container monitoring architecture and the three major metrics to look out for Amazon ECS. Check out the links below to start building. Thanks for watching Back to Basics. See you next time.